All right, so after creating our blog collection, if you go into pages, you can see that we've already got the post template created, but we do need to create a single blog page to house all those cards. So what I'll do is click create a new page here. We'll call this blog, and I'll hit create. So now we have an empty page here. And we are starting from an existing template before, so I can reuse components that I've made from the last project to kind of create the base for this. And the way I like to do this quickly is using a series of shortcuts. The one I use the most is Command E, which allows kind of a find anything tool to come up, and you can search anything in here. So I can search a div, I can search a heading, I can search also components I've made. So I'm going to look for the nav bar component and I'll drop that in here, which I've already made. I'm also going to search for a section and then I'll click outside so I don't put my footer inside of my section. And I will also hit a footer. So the green one is something I've already built. So we kind of have our template to go from here. Another thing I'll do is right click and click wrap in div block. So I'm going to wrap my section and my footer inside of a main div. This is a good practice just for structuring everything out. So I'll go into settings, hit tag, and we'll call this main. So this is a really good base for a page. And this is what we will build the rest of our blog page on. So within our section, let's go ahead and create our posts. So I'll add in a quick heading here saying blog. I'll wrap it in a quick div block with some bottom margin. And we're ready to go. So the next thing we need to do is bring in all of our blog cards. And the way that we'll do that is with a collection list. So I'm going to click on container, hit control E, and look for collection list and drop that in here. By default, you'll see something like this where it shows you a wrapper. And it's not connected to anything, and it won't let you do anything until you connect this to something. I laugh at that because there have been times where I've tried to just start dropping divs in here, and no, you have to connect it to something first. So the source of our collection list will be our blog posts. So I'll click that here. And once I do that, you can see that it populates with all of the blog posts that we currently have. So now that we have this, we can start creating our template for each of those blog items. And I'll go ahead and start adding elements to this and you'll see what happens. So if I add in a div here, you can see that all of them get a div. If I add an image here, you can see all of them get an image. I'll add in some heading and some paragraph text as well. And I'm going to go ahead and connect these to our CMS database so we can start seeing what each of these things are going to look like. So for example, if I click on this image in one of the cards, click the gear icon, you'll see that next to where our image usually is, where we would choose one, you'll see a little purple icon, and this is where we can connect to the CMS. So if I click this, you can see that I can either connect it to main image or thumbnail image. We want thumbnail, so I'll click that. And once I do, you can see that all of the things get the thumbnail image added into them. I can do the same thing with our text field. So if I add in, click on the gear icon here and click the purple, I can click on name for this. And then for our paragraph element, I can click on post summary. So that's all well and good, but this is not the layout we want. We probably want them to be in some kind of gridded card. So what I can do is kind of go back to the structure that happened when we brought in this collection list. So I'm going to click on the navigator and kind of show you what got dropped in. So when we pulled in this collection list, we got a collection list wrapper, which wraps a collection list, which wraps an item. So you have this sort of three div structure, whereas the collection item is not one item, but just all of them, but we're just kind of able to edit one here. So with our collection list, this is what I'm going to use to create the grid. So I'm going to apply a class to this, we'll call it blog list, and then I'm going to apply the grid layout to this and do, I'll do a three column grid. So now it's starting to look like a blog. For our image, I'm going to wrap this in a link block. And I want, when users click on it, it'll take them to the post page. So what I'll do for that is click the gear icon here. The purple is going to be dynamic. If you haven't gathered that yet, anything purple is linking dynamically. So I can click on this and I can choose the current blog post and it'll connect to our blog post. If I had a URL that I wanted it to link to, I could also do that in here. Also, so long as you are in the collection list, you'll see options for connecting things dynamically off to the side here. So this is great if you have colors that you're trying to link up as well. They'll show up over here. I'm going to call this image blog image link. So I have my blog image link. I'm going to wrap it in one more div block. I'll call this blog image wrapper. And I will also set it to relative. What I'm about to do is add in our category. I would have added it into our kind of link block here, but you can't add in a nested collection within a link. So I've added another div so that it's not in a link, and I can hit collection list here, and I'm going to connect it to the source of categories. So you can see our categories showing up here. So with this specifically, I'm going to add in a text block and connect it to the name of our categories so we can see them. So we now have a nested collection list. One note I want to make quickly here is that you can't have more than one nested collection list in a list. By nested, I mean if you look over here, we have a collection list here, and then inside our collection list, we have one nested collection list. If I were to go into this item and try to add another collection list, it'll say, hey, no, not allowed. And there are ways around that using different JavaScript libraries, but from a base in Webflow, you can only have one. So just keep that in mind. Next, we are going to make this look pretty. This isn't looking so great on our various lists here just to have them all underneath. What I want to do is have them all next to each other and also going over the image. So to do that, we'll start by naming some of these classes here. So with our collection list wrapper, I will call this blog cat list wrapper. I'll go down one by hitting the down key and I'll call this blog cat list. Then I'll go down one more and I'll call this blog cat list item. If I know how to spell. All right. And so with our list, I'm going to change this to flex so that they're all next to each other. I'll give it a gap of 8 pixels for now. And then for our list item, since it's going to be over these images, I am going to style this to have maybe a black background with just a little bit of opacity going through it. I'll give it a little bit of padding as well. One trick here is if you want to style both the top and the bottom, you can press Option. And so I'll do this as well for this side. So we'll do 8 and 4. And then I'll change this to white. And it's still a little too dark for my taste, so I'm going to change this to 6. And that looks pretty good. And now, on top of this, I think I'm going to put this inside of the image wrapper. So I'm just going to drag this out to here. And what I just remembered is you cannot put a collection list wrapper inside of a link. So what I can do instead is click on our blog image link, wrap this in a div block, put the blog cat list wrapper in here, and we'll give this a name so that we could add some styling to it, blog image wrap. And then I will give this blog image wrap a position of relative, and then our blog category list wrapper a position of absolute. I'll also put it so it's at the bottom. I'll give it a little bit of margin. We'll do 16. Oop, something made it go too big. And then 16 on this side. And I don't like how it bunches up like this, So I'm going to click blog cat list, and then we'll use one of the lesser known flexes over here, and we will wrap it up. I kind of want them to stack here in this left-hand corner, so we'll see which one does that. I think it's that, because that goes that way, and that goes that way. So yeah, I think we want it to wrap up like this. And that looks pretty good to me. And then when it doesn't have anything, yeah, looks like I already had this class in here. But if it's an empty state, I have a class right now called hide that just sets the display to none. So that'll be good for if there's nothing to show there. So we have that here. We know now if we hover over it, it's a link. But where is it linking to? So for our image link, we want to make sure we hit the purple over here and make sure it links to our current blog post. And then also, I'm going to right-click this again, wrap this in a link block, put the paragraph inside of it too. We'll call this blog card text wrap. And I'm just going to unstyle everything and change our text back. But what this is just another way for us to link to the blog. So I'll click over here and choose the collection page of the current blog post. I'll also give this a hover style. So if I click hover, I can change what it's going to look like just on hover. And for this, I'll make it really simple. We'll just say the opacity goes down to maybe 75%. I think that's good. And then I'll take the hover off and add a transition so it's not so stark. So now, if I hit preview, you can see that this hovers too. And then I think I'll also add a hover state to our image. So if I go to image, click hover, we'll bump this down to 75, and then none again. And you'll see if I don't add in the transition, it's like a really stark change. So I'll go to image and just add transition. One last thing here with our list is currently it's showing all of our blog items. If we only wanted to show maybe the first 10, we could hit this as 10, but we do want to be able to see the others. So the other option is to just see a certain number of them page by page. You can click paginate items. And that way, it'll only show you however many you want to see per page, and it'll add a little next and previous button at the bottom that you can style so you can cycle through the rest of the items. So if I hit 9 here, I can sort of browse through the different pages of them and see what they look like. It's also in this view that you can filter items down. So if you only wanted to show maybe the most recent ones, you could filter by publish date. You could also use this to make sure that blogs that are not supposed to come out yet are not coming out yet. You can make sure that only blogs from this year are on this page, that kind of thing. This is where you can do that. This is also where you can add in sort order, so you can choose to sort them alphabetically by publish date. Another thing folks will do if they want to add a custom order is in the Webflow collection itself, you can add a number field here. And you can sort by largest to smallest number. I usually do that because if you set one thing as one, it's hard to add a new number, you know, that's lower than one. So it's helpful to sort in descending order from largest to smallest. So that is kind of an option if you want to do a custom order type of thing here. That's how you do it. But I think that's it for our blog collection page. I think we have everything set up well that we can go ahead and start building out our post page. So we are going to move on to that now.
If you found this video useful and want to learn more, be sure to check out our complete guide to Webflow tutorial. It provides comprehensive tutorials and expert guidance to help you build professional grade websites, and also has courses on other no-code tools. And if you haven't done so already, or if you're new here, subscribe to the channel for more content like this, share it with a friend, and if you have any questions, leave a comment below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.